So here's what I did when I was starting out and when I couldn't steal my mom's credit card. Let me start off this video by saying that I have nothing against live streaming. In fact, almost all my DJ friends do it now. But the thing is, not all of us have the means nor access to live stream. Some of us don't have fast internet or even the tools to make a decent stream with professional grade DJ audio. Tools like this or this. And that's the problem. If you want to make a good live stream happen, you gotta buy and have those tools. Why not just do something more productive with something that you already have and do something that'll last longer than a single stream? So here's what I suggest you should rather be doing with your time to better boost your online presence and be a better DJ. Number one, make video mixes like how I do on YouTube. So if you want to make something similar to that, it's pretty easy if you put in the work. You're gonna need to do 5 things. Number one, conceptualize a mix. Number two, set up your equipment and practice that mix over and over again. Number three, when you're ready, set up your camera. Number four, press record on your DJ software and camera and turn on screen record on your computer. Number five, after recording everything together in a perfect take, simply import those 3 clips through editing software and put that mix together. Now, there are 2 things that I like about making video mixes. Number one is that you also practice and get better in DJing. Recording that perfect set will take a lot of time, trust me. So the more you repeat your mix over and over again, the better you'll become at practicing whatever mix or transition you're trying to show off. Remember, if you can't do it in front of a camera, how can you even do it in front of an audience? Number two is that you make content to better market yourself as a DJ. Growing a fan base on YouTube, SoundCloud, Instagram, and even Facebook is really the new battlefield for DJs who want to get booked and recognized. You see, if you're not a producer, you gotta show the world how you mix and what you mix. So the more you focus on growing your brand through making content, the better off you'll be in the long run. So make those mixes and videos. Now, before we move on to the next thing to do, which is a bit controversial, here's first a quick bonus tip. Learn a new skill, like how to scratch or even how to produce. Lately, I've been learning how to produce on Skillshare. I took King Arthur DJ's class on remixing dance music, digital production basics. There it teaches you how to remix songs and make them sound like your own. And those lessons are perfect for DJs who not only want to up their production game, but their DJ performance game as well. So if you want to check out that music production masterclass and a whole lot more, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link down below will get 2 free months of premium membership on Skillshare so you can explore your creativity. And Skillshare is an online learning community that offers membership with meaning. With over 20,000 classes in music production, graphic design, songwriting, and more, which are all fueled by passionate creatives like myself, you're pretty much set for life if you want to learn anything new, efficiently, effectively, and economically, because an annual subscription on Skillshare just costs less than $10 a month. So make 2020 a year where you explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity with Skillshare's online classes. Now, number two may piss off some people, but anyway, here it is. Download free music. So one of the questions I get the most in my videos is, where do I download my music? And the short answer to that is, now I download most of my music through DJ record pools like DJ City and BPM Supreme. You can think of these record pools as libraries of music you can download for a monthly price. Now, the thing is, not everyone here has a means to afford a record pool. Most DJs, at least young beginners, can even barely afford DJ equipment. What more a monthly paid subscription service? So here's what I did when I was starting out and when I couldn't steal my mom's credit card. I ripped music from YouTube and SoundCloud and I am not proud of it. The sound quality of what I ripped sucked and I felt pretty guilty to the artists whom I downloaded new music from. Anyway, here's how I did it. Now, I'm not encouraging you to do it, I'm just letting you know how. Number one, find the track you want in YouTube and SoundCloud and copy the URL. Number 2, Google YouTube MP3 Ripper and choose whichever website suits your fancy. Number 3, paste your link and click download. Number 4, feel guilty because you're now a pirate. And the third best thing to do now instead of live streaming is, with your new music and your library of tracks, properly prep them. And you can find a super handy video on how to do just that over here. But to summarize it, first, analyze your tracks. So here's how to do this on Serato and on Recordbox DJ and on Traktor. Then cue point the beginning of the track you want to use and cue point the sections where you want to mix in and out. So how I make sure to always mix perfectly on beat and on time is by cue pointing my tracks. So I place a total of 3 cue points. One at the intro section. So the position of this cue point will be 32 beats away from the end of the intro. The second one will be at the chorus section. So this cue point's position will be 32 beats away from the end of the chorus. And the last one will be at the beginning of the outro section. Now this is a very tedious process, but it's a good practice to do when you download new stuff. Because every new track you'll download and prepare can instantly be used to DJ professionally with. And that's it. So if you made it this far, let me know which tip was your favorite and why. And with that said, thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.